Welcome to Strength of Materials. Compound stresses or complex stresses. In this video, we will be having the expression for principal stresses and principal planes. So let us consider a general two-dimensional element subjected to stresses as shown in figure. So we are able to see the particular stresses are here. The stresses such as summation f of x, summation f of y, tau x shear stress, tau x shear stress, and the x and y coordinates. Also, AB is with summation sigma f x, and CD face plane is again with sigma x, BC is sigma y, and AD is with sigma y. So tau is acting here and tau is acting here. Here is the diagonal tension which is acting. As we know that the normal stress component on any arbitrary plane, is given by sigma theta or sigma x. So sigma theta or sigma x is equals to sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus sigma x minus sigma y by 2 cos 2 theta minus tau xy sin 2 theta. So this was the earlier equation where we have determined on any arbitrary plane the particular stresses are able to be calculated as the principal normal stress and tangential stress. So this is the particular equation for that. Sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus of sigma x minus sigma y by 2 into cos 2 theta minus tau xy sin 2 theta. For sigma x to be maximum or minimum, for sigma x such that whatever the sigma t or sigma theta or sigma x is this should be maximum or minimum, the necessary condition is sigma dx divided d sigma dx by d theta, means we need to differentiate with respect to the theta value. So in this part we can see that the particular differentiation, the equation number 1, the earlier equation with respect to theta, we are able to see that d sigma x divided by d theta is equals to, when we are going to differentiate, that time a value of plus is going to become as a 0, and sigma x minus sigma y divided by 2 into cos is again turned for the sine of minus, minus sine 2 theta into 2 minus of tau xy cos 2 theta into 2. So after differentiating, this is the equation. Now we will be taking it on the other side. So this 2 and the 2 which is here is going to get cancelled. So these two are going to get cancelled. This 2 and this 2 is getting to cancel. So remaining is only this 2, because here is the minus sign. We are not able to cancel this part. So taking these two terms, sigma fx, sigma x minus sigma y on the either side. So this term we will be taking on the left hand side, on this particular equal to side, this side. So this value becomes as sigma x minus sigma y will be in the bracket as minus. Here it is coming as minus because of your positive sign, and minus sine 2 theta on the other side will be becoming as positive. So minus sigma x minus sigma y into sine 2 theta is equals to 2 tau xy cos of 2 theta. So we are able to have this on the both the signatures. Now we will take cos on the other side and plus minus of sigma x minus sigma y on the other side. So when we take, say, sine 2 theta divided by cos 2 theta is equals to minus of 2 times tau xy divided by sigma x minus sigma y. Now tan theta, sine theta by 2, sine 2 theta divided by cos 2 theta, similar part, we can say this as a tan 2 theta. So minus of 2 tau xy divided by sigma minus sigma x minus sigma y is the second equation wherein we can find out. Now equation number 2 represents the expression for a principal plane on which principal stresses are going to act. So this equation is the expression for principal planes on which the principal stresses are acting, such that sigma fx x it is or sigma y it is. We can take a AB plane or we can take a BC plane, or it can be a AD plane or it can be a CD plane, whatever the plane can be. So on that particular plane, the principal stresses are acting, that particular plane is this equation number 2 will be giving. Now coming for the graphical representation of equation number 2 is as shown in the figure. So this is the particular graphical representation wherein we are going to determine. So the equation is in this way, ABD. So we are able to have AB as -2 tau xy and AD as in bracket sigma x minus sigma y, and BD as the particular part of AB plus BC square, AB square plus AD square. So this is sigma xy whole square plus of -2 tau xy square. So 2 square is becoming as the particular 4 here, and the tau xy square is square, and root of that is this. So this is the Pythagoras theorem equation which we have applied to get value of BD, and the angle will be here as 2 times theta. So theta is what we already know in the previous principal planes, normal stresses and tangential stresses. From the figure we can write sin 2 theta and cos theta. So this is the right angle triangle. We can easily write down the sin theta and cos 2 theta. So sin 2 theta is equals to minus or plus. So I'll be writing it in the two ways, it can be plus or minus. So minus or plus 2 tau xy divided by square root of sigma x minus sigma y whole square plus 4 times tau xy square. So I'll write this as the equation number 3 as a sin 2 theta. And when I write for cos 2 theta, plus or minus, so this will be coming on the upper side, the AD part, sigma x minus sigma y divided by root of sigma x minus sigma y square plus 4 times tau xy square, writing it as fourth equation. Substituting equation 3 and 4 in the equation number 1. So the earlier first equation, wherever the values are there as a sin 2 theta and cos 2 theta, there we are going to substitute in this equation and we will be finding what the equation is going to give us. So once we substitute here in this equation, the sigma x 1 sigma x 2 whatever may be, sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus of sigma x minus sigma y by 2. So when we are substituting the cos 2 theta, that is plus or minus sigma x minus sigma y divided by square root of sigma x minus sigma y whole square plus 4 times tau xy square bracket, this is the part of total cos theta. Minus tau xy sin theta it was, so minus or plus 2 tau xy divided by square root of sigma x minus sigma y whole square plus 4 times tau xy whole square, that we are going to again substitute, we are able to get this particular value. So here the minus term is going to get cancelled, sigma x and sigma y if they are only the same part, so it will become as a half. And when we are multiplying the particular value inside the particular part, so this will become as the square, and tau xy will become also square. So this is going inside, it is square. So minus into minus plus it is, so plus into plus it is plus or minus. So it is half here, sigma x sigma y going inside will become as sigma x minus sigma y whole square. So substituting these values, and then we will be taking, so why it is taking inside means this part only we are taking inside the bracket part, and plus and minus signs we are keeping as it is to get final equations. So sigma x 1 sigma x 2 is equals to sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus or minus half of. So now making the LCM of these two parts, we can easily say that these two parts, when we are taking the part of LCM, so sigma x minus sigma y whole square plus 4 times tau xy square divided by the sigma root of sigma x minus sigma y square plus 4 times tau xy holds tau xy square. So we are able to find out this particular value. So sigma x minus sigma x1 sigma x2 will be equals to this is the expression of final principal stresses, sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus or minus of square root of so we can say this part is square root. So when we remove the particular part of the squaring, so we are able to get this term as getting cancelled. So sigma x minus sigma y square plus 4 times tau xy whole square. So this is the fifth number equation known as the expression for principal stress and principal planes. So equation number 5 is the required expression for principal stresses. And thank you and see you in the next video.